master data, product, material, training mode. Let me go to change mode first. A material in SAP is again not an exclusive first edition distribution. A material can be accessed by so many departments. Just like how the finance and sales access a customer, in case of material, it is still more work. There, I mean, at least the customer must have only two modules accessing the customer master. In this case, we have so many. We have the sales, we will access the material, purchasing will access the material, production people will access the material, warehouse management people will access the material. So there will be so many views. There are so many views here. Basic data, like how there is general data in customer, which means like irrespective of which department is accessing, that must be, the data must be shown. In customer master we had the general data, similarly we have the basic data here. And whatever is marked with sales, that is relevant for us. For example, sales organization data 1, sales organization data 2, general plant data, sales 6. Okay. And plant, yeah, that is a general plant. Plant stuff is normally taken by the production people. Okay, ours has the general plant data. Okay. So one is these four. And the basic data 1 and 2 is obviously for everybody. So only these things we have to see, or we have to change if you want to make any changes. If you choose everything and if you try to make changes, it will take you to lot of things which none of us know. There will be so many things. I mean, like you will not only will get confused, and towards the end you will end up without saving extra, without making any changes. Okay. So, to avoid those kind of situations, we choose the views that is only relevant for us. So, for us, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6. Okay. View is like, I mean, like, material is accessible by so many models other than sales and distribution. So everybody will be having their set of data to fill in that material master. So those set of, so the data set can be so many views. So we have to choose only the views that are relevant for us. For the sales and distribution, only these, whatever I have marked, these are relevant. The other views are not relevant for us. So I'm going to select, I'm going to show you and talk about only these views. So I have selected these things. I press continue. Since I had chosen the general plan, and since we have chosen the sales organization view, the system will be asking the plant data, plant number as well as the sales organization number. So we are in the basic data 1 field. First one is the basic unit of measure. What is basic unit of measure? Okay. Okay. So coming to the petrol, why can't we measure in millimeters? Now the technology is so advanced, I can even measure what, how much each drop can come in. What is the volume of each drop? So the base unit of measure is the lowest unit of measure in the your organization is handling. For example, like you have told, there are meters, then we have the, you want to call, we can even measure in containers. Okay. So let us say in case of small screen article, we can measure in pieces, 10 pieces will be put into one box, okay. 100 boxes will be put into one carton, and 1000 boxes will be put into one container. So what are the unit of measures we have? One is piece, one is carton, one is box, and one is container. But the base unit is the lowest one in which you are handling in your business. For example, in the business I am handling only box containers, box carton and container. Then my base unit measure of the article will be the box, because that is the lowest one of those three. So the base unit of measure is the lowest unit in which we are measuring the article. Then comes the material group. This material group says, so this group this article belongs to. 208 belongs to 208 belongs to hard disk. Can you see that? So this product 18102 belongs to hard disk basically. And next one is old material number. Even before SAP came into play, the business would have been up and running already. They were doing well, that is why they are moving to SAP. Okay. So they must have been using some legacy system. And when you are migrating from legacy system to SAP system, you cannot discard all your old articles or old descriptions, old article numbers just like that, and take up the SAP conventional code. The users won't be that much fun. Who is on speaker? Okay. So the users won't be comfortable with that. Hello? Is anybody on speaker? Because there's an echo. Can you put it up? Yeah. Use the headphones for this. So you use the old material number, that is the legacy material number in the old material number field. Okay, this is not a mandatory field. If you don't enter, okay, it is fine. If you enter it, it will be useful for you when you are searching for the SAP article. Then you have the division. What is the division? Can anybody give the division? Definition for division? It's a material group. Correct. So we group the material from based on certain characteristics, similarities. Okay. This belongs to division 7. Division 7 is in high tech product division. Then you have the product hierarchy. So daily business, we used to segregate the products in terms of hierarchy. For example, let me say I can classify as let me talk about the simple object, the mouse. Okay. So mouse can be, I can classify the mouse into let me say that I am having the first product called electronics. I am grouping the products under a broad category first. I think first my first level is electronics. Below the electronics I say I have entertainment, I have peripherals or computer, then I have the some other education and educational product. So below electronics I have three. Okay. So then in the peripheral below the peripherals I have the computer. Below the computers I have the stack. Out of the stack is the then I assign this mouse to the stack of No. Okay. So how is my hierarchy going on? Electronics to peripherals to computers to fabs. Okay. So this is the kind of product hierarchy we are building. Product hierarchy, even though it is not a mandatory concept in SAP MSD, it is very useful in grouping your products, and you can use the product hierarchy for your pricing. For example, tomorrow if I say I want to give discount to all my electronic products, then I can define my discount at the electronic level only. Whatever I define at the electronic level, that will be automatically flowing to the rest of the items, like your sub items or sub nodes. Okay. So let me, the first five is change the first node or top node. The next 5 digits shows the next node. So we will see the first 5 digits is 00125. Belongs to hardware. Okay. I choose that. So what is my next level? Next level is 00100. 00100, that is PC. Then my next level is 00130, drive. So this product belongs to the hierarchy of 00, yeah, it belongs to the hierarchy of hardware, PC and drive. Okay. So this hierarchy and everything will be defined by the materials management people, but we will be using this for our discount purposes. Okay. So then is the, I will skip out what are the things not relevant to us. Okay. So then we have the gross weight and net weight of this article. What is the weight unit we are measuring in kilograms? And if you know the volume unit, you can enter it here. And even if you don't, it's not a problem. But if you enter the volume here, it will be very much useful in transportation module. Because transportation will say, how much of volume this article takes us. So when you are planning a transportation, for example, it will be useful in planning your container, which type of container or which vehicle you have to do, that will be useful. Basic data 2 is mostly used by engineering products. For example, whenever you have the diagram, engineering diagram for those things, or if it is any some other special material like dangerous goods. So this can, if you have any of those values, you can enter it here. This indicator is dangerous goods profile. Okay. So if it is a dangerous good, you can enter the profile here. And if it is any part of engineering product, for example your axle shaft or your some other chassis, so then you will be having the diagram, relevant diagram for that. Okay. So what is the document number and diagram number, in which page it is, so this kind of things you can enter it. Okay. So the basic data and basic data 1 and 2 doesn't have any company specific or sales data.